Hey, Lexi here, and today I want to talk about something a little different for my channel, the time I tried to join the robotics team in my high school. I'm a big fan of girls joining STEM programs. Science will always have a special place in my life.
Discovery. Innovation.
Impact. Inclusion.
Teamwork.
Fun!
But in my high school, many moons ago, I guess they weren't really ready for this yet. I hope they are now. Back in high school, my best friend Sandra would come early to school and volunteer in the science lab rooms with another student every day. They would grade tests for science teachers and just chat with the teachers sometimes. One day, a teacher she didn't know too well, Mr. Mustache, overheard her talking to the other student about science and tech stuff.
You want to do some science?
Stick to the science, yeah?
Stick to the science.
Sandra has been a big fan of tech ever since she was a kid. No surprise to me, but to Mr. Mustache, this was apparently a very big surprise. A girl who liked tech? Unheard of, apparently.
Look, it's encrypted.
That's so cute.
Mr. Mustache gets all excited about this and tells Sandra,
"Hey, you should join the robotics team."
Through hands-on, engaging robotics challenges, FIRST ignites passion in STEM for kids ages 6 through 18.
He was in charge of the team. He said he
never had a girl on the robotics team before.
Never? Mr. Mustache was forgetting something. Sandra tells him,
"No thanks, I heard not good things about the team from a friend."
That friend was me. Mr. Mustache, completely flabbergasted, demands to know who this person was. Sandra says Lexi Conjures. He thinks for a moment and says,
"Oh, that one that came with the tall kid?"
He was talking about my other friend at the time, Joe. Sandra didn't know who tall kid was, though. She had no idea Joe joined the team, essentially to follow me around even though he had zero interest in robotics, science, or really much of anything.
"I don't know,"
Sandra said.
"But Lexi said when she was on the team freshman year, she wasn't allowed to do anything."
"I understand that you are being excluded from working on the new social network project, which was assigned to this team. And when something gets assigned to a team at Speculate, it means the entire team. Got it?"
And that's exactly what happened. Back during my freshman year, I'd come to the lab room to help prep the robot for the FIRST robotics competition.
At face value, FIRST is a robot competition. But at the end of the day, it's so much more than that.
And every day, everyone on the team, including Mr. Mustache, would tell me they don't need any help. They all knew I was on the team, but they wouldn't let me touch a thing. Must have thought I had cooties. I had Joe. That was pretty close. He'd follow me around while I made the rounds every day asking, "Hi, can I help?" Every single individual group. From the soldering, to the wiring, to the programming, to the building. No one would teach me, talk to me about what they were doing, or even let me hand them things they needed.
We learn a lot about leadership, how to communicate with others, problem solving.
Working together.
Miss Mustache told Sandra,
"Oh, that guy had some interest in the team."
He talked about how I just stand near toolkit all the time. This was somewhat true. After I'd be told by everyone I can't help or touch a single thing, I'd go organize the giant rolling toolbox. It was the only thing I could do to help that no one could tell me I couldn't do. And when anyone needed anything, I was there, and I knew exactly where it was. I essentially made myself the equipment manager when no one on the team would let me play. Joe would stand there asking me what a Phillips head screwdriver versus a flathead was. I really should have questioned more why he wanted to be on the robotics team with me. I genuinely thought he was interested back then. Mr. Mustache went on to talk about Joe, the tall kid, with Sandra to prove why I wasn't interested in the team. The way he talked about it, you would think I only showed up because Joe was there. Boy, did he have that backwards. Joe was the one who always threatened to quit the team because he didn't feel like going. And I'd ask him not to, because then I'd be all alone and the only one who never got to do anything or got talked to. I should have let him quit, though. He didn't care about any of it, and the way Mr. Mustache talked to Sandra, Joe was probably a big part of why no one let me get involved. He made me look like the tag-along. I don't see how that works. I was the one who was asking questions all the time. He would stand there doing nothing, just follow me around, but apparently I'm the tag-along. Because I'm a girl. Or because I'm little. I don't know which. Either way, it makes no sense.
Being in FIRST, like, I realized I am smart enough to do this. It doesn't matter what background you come from.
I went to every meeting for months, including the FIRST Robotics meet that year, where I also got to do nothing. But at least it was a more exciting location, where I got to do nothing. Sandra told Mr. Mustache all of that. He stared at Sandra like she had five heads. I'm not surprised. Mr. Mustache was one of the people who tell me,
"Don't help. Don't touch that. Don't break that."
Why would he remember me as someone with an interest in robotics if all he remembered was that? And Joe, towering over me with a blank expression, asked me what soldering was. The bell rang and Sandra escaped the conversation. And to my knowledge, there was no girl who joined the team between when I was on the team and when I graduated. If a girl joins the STEM program, don't treat them like idiots who don't know how anything works. I was trying to join the team because for 3 years in junior high, I was on a Lego robotics team as a programmer. My team did so well that we won the state competition and went on to nationals. My teacher at that time personally told me I should join the robotics team when I got to high school because he thought I was really good at it.
I think it's incredibly important for youth to see careers in science and engineering as a possibility for them.
That, on top of the fact that I really liked building things, made me think that this was going to go really well. And even if I didn't have experience with all of that, I'm not sure every guy in that team had experience before they joined. If you can teach them from scratch, you can teach girls too.
If you start them off young, their possibilities are endless.
Be inclusive. Make them feel welcome.
It definitely made me look at other challenges and be like, hey, I want to try that.
I know that I can do it now.
Or they might stand by the toolbox feeling sorry for themselves, but too stubborn to quit, like I did. Or they may be too afraid to join at all, like Sandra. What's funny to me is a year after Mr. Mustache talked to Sandra about this, he had Joe as a student for the first time in Earth Science. Earth science in my school was mainly relegated people who have trouble in school or aren't trying particularly hard, depending on the student. Joe, well, you can guess which one Joe was. Sandra later graded one of his papers, and it seemed like Joe didn't try much harder in that class than he did on the team. I, on the other hand, was in honor science that year. Funny how things work out. Now, years later, Sandra has a degree in programming and engineering, and she works as an IT coordinator. They missed out.
Do you see it?
Yeah.
I hope Mr. Mustache learned that there are girls who are interested in tech and science. You just need to treat them like everyone else on the team. Either that, or I hope Mr. Mustache retired and someone else took over. Have you ever experienced something like this? Something you tried to join but people gave you a hard time because of your gender? Or did you try to help someone in this situation? Let me know in the comments below. I want to hear your take on this. If you like that story, subscribe. Ring the bell. It's not very scientific, but there's two buttons involved. That's gotta count for something.
Keep talking. So hot.
And hey, while you're at it, maybe give this video a like so I know if you want to hear more stories like this one. So, until next time, let girls learn to love STEM, include everyone who wants to be included, and always be creating. Bye, guys.